SRI is the system of rice intensification, an agroecological rice growing methodology that is now used by over 10 million farmers in 60 countries. Described as a major game changer in the fight for global food security, SRI is pro-poor and pro-women. The EU-funded SRI LMB program is working in the Lower Mekong Basin, encouraging the adoption of SRI in Laos, Thailand, Cambodia and Vietnam. It's collecting data and research from 12,000 participating farmers in over 405 field experiments with the aim of scaling up SRI activities in the future. Rice is a staple food for the 185 million inhabitants here, over half of whom rely on agriculture for their living. Of those, many are food insecure, but the potential for SRI LMB to benefit rice growers is significant, particularly for women, as they form the majority of the workforce. The program headquarters is in the Asian Institute of Technology, AIT, near Bangkok, Thailand.
We come up with this idea to have some kind of regional project that talks about SRI, where we can have systematic documentations of the actions implemented and the result achieved, so that science should not be left behind in this whole process.
SRI requires less seed, less water, and aims to reduce dependence on chemicals while enhancing organic matter in the soil. According to the UN's Food and Agriculture Organization, or FAO, it is climate smart, and as such, has been proven to produce higher yields while remaining resilient to the stresses produced by climate change. And it requires less water, which also reduces greenhouse gas emissions.
This is more environmentally and economically and even socially responsible and feasible way of rice cultivation.
SRI is also knowledge-based. Its benefits are demonstrated and passed on from farmer to farmer, now through increasing support from the international community, as in the case of SRI LMB.
We had an idea that if we have some kind of intervention which is knowledge intensive, that requires less input to address the food security of the household but also of the region, why not?
One of the unique factors about SRI is farmers innovate and adapt it to make it work for their environment. It's a practice that is farmer-led, based loosely on four principles. One, using younger seedlings. Two, planting in wide spaces, singly. Three, aerating the soil while controlling weeds. And four, controlling water. But how those principles are applied very much depends on the farmers and the environment in which they're working.
So that's the idea behind SRI everywhere else, and it holds good even in Laos conditions too. Specifically, if we come to the SRI LMB, one of the objectives we have is to link this to the food security of the households.
หมายความว่าเฮ็ดน้อยแล้วได้หลายเนาะเฮ็ดกับครอบครัวที่ว่ามีดินน้อยและได้หับผลผลิตหลายอันนี้คือเป้าหมายให้ครอบครัวนั้นมีอยู่มีจนแล้วก็เพิ่มผลผลิตเข้าในให้สูงขึ้นแล้วก็เพื่อลดพรการใช้จ่ายของชาวนาเนี่ยลงโดยเฉพาะแม่นการลดพรต้นทุนการผลิตการลดพรแนวพันธุ์ข้าว
Previous attempts to introduce SRI in Laos have not always met with success, in part because interventions have tended to adopt a top-down approach which failed to win over farmer confidence. But building on lessons learned, SRI LMB has adopted a radically different approach, engaging with the farmers in a more interactive way. Training sessions are conducted around FAO's Farmer Field School approach, where farmers are brought together in groups to experience SRI firsthand.
Before the whole program started, there was something called as a Central Farmer Participatory Action Research. It was at the provincial level. And after that, they further went down to the districts. Each of those sites would have somewhere between 20, 25, to up to 30 farmers. So they come together once, about four times during the season at critical growth periods of the crop.
Dokeo has embraced the idea of SRI and can see the potential benefit for her family. Farmers here have grown rice in the same way for many generations, and SRI is a new approach that is not always easily introduced. These farmers are transplanting SRI for the first time.
Well, I think the catchphrase is seeing is believing. We both come together, farmers as well as outsiders, and nobody has got the whole complete picture. We may know some bits of the crop, but actual cultivation, the farmer is a master. For example, I was there transplanting, and I just hope that those three lines come out, you know?
The challenge here is also to adapt SRI practice to rain-fed areas, where the control of water is less manageable.
In this particular case, we are trying to figure out which of the practices that are classified under the system of rice intensification, which of them actually work in a particular area and which of them do not.
Much of the country's lowland rice areas have little irrigation available, which means that these farmers must adapt SRI to their own local situation.
We are always concerned about site specificity. We want to try out something on a small area and we want to do it together with the farmers. Against preset objectives, we want to learn what's happening with actual data collection. And at the end of the season, we all sit and discuss about what works, what doesn't work.
So we are interested to see the pattern of response from farmers, basically in terms of adaptation of SRI practices. So this is the research component. Similarly, we have a policy and advocacy component, and that is taken care by Oxfam America.
Kanika Keo works with Oxfam and is policy advisor to the SRI LMB program.
We aim to influence the policymaker as well, why SRI is important and why SRI and women should become one of the top agenda.
Last year, based on the report we received from all four countries, 12,000 farmers were directly involved in farmer participatory action research, and 55% were women. So the women are contributing a lot, and they are also reporting higher yield and higher benefit.
มันก็ดีใจอ่ะคือผลผลิตมันดี ข้าวมันก็แตกโกดีอะไรดีเงี้ยเราก็ภูมิใจเจ็บตรงนี้หน่อยก็อย่างน้อยก็ได้ผลผิดมาพอใจอ่ะ
In the SRI LMB program area, average SRI paddy yields are now 4.7 tons per hectare, which is 66% more than the regional average. Farmers' profits have almost doubled, and these gains were achieved with 50% higher water productivity and 66% higher labour productivity. Now SRI LMB is looking to the future.
Yeah, I think for the future, we should be working for the market. And this smallholder, they can have opportunity to enter into market and make more profitable business, not only just to address the household concern, but also the national interest. So this is what we are aiming as a part of next intervention.